my last video, I showed how I made this easy to build Mazda MX5 based chain drive differential. There was no machining and no welding required on this. It used these housed self-aligning bearings on the outer spigots. It used the standard MX5 flanged output shafts, which just push in. The problem being, it's not possible to put an oil seal on the outside. Normally, it'd be an oil seal like this, which is a 35mm seal, which rides on this journal here. Now, this journal is sticking way out past the bearings, so there's no way to seal an oil seal out there. So what I'll do is make up an extended housing that pushes into the bearing. In here there's a recess. The recess is about 14 or 15 millimeters deep, so there's plenty of space for me to push in a carrier. And again, rather than machining a carrier, what I'm going to do is do a 3D printed seal carrier. So this seal will sit out about here, and the housing will push inside. On the original version of this, I just put a dust seal on, glued on a dust seal just to stop any muck getting inside, but that wouldn't keep any lubricants from coming out of the way. So ideally you want to have either a semi-fluid grease or a really heavy gear oil inside the differential, just to grease up the gears inside or lubricate the gears inside. But the problem being, it would flow out past the journal here and run out. So an oil seal is required. So I'll measure up and draw up a seal or a seal carrier to take these seals. It should be a simple case of pushing them in and then sealing on these surfaces here. It will work on both of the types of differential. This is the larger of the differentials. This was the 7-inch version. And then there was also the 6-inch version. Again, used a similar housed bearing. We've got a recess in there. And again, the output shafts push in, and the seal journal sits back out here. So again, a little extended oil seal carrier pushed in will do the job. Uses the same 35mm seal. This is a 35 internal diameter seal, 52mm outside diameter by 8mm. Fairly cheap, I think they're about £3 each. Few stringy bits inside it. Not very good sealings on it. Print came out fairly well on the outside. A few little bobbles where it randomly started a layer. These can be sanded off and tidied up. The 28.5mm internal bore seems fine on the shaft of the output shaft. Biggest problem came with these inner sealings that overhangs, and they're printing that way up. They're all very stringy. So what I can do, I think, is put a very small, maybe a half mil step at that junction there, and then just a constant taper down. And it should be able to step down without creating all these funny little blobs. You can see where that 2mm chamfer was, seems prints okay. So, you know, even if I come down at about that rate, 45 degrees down to there, we should be okay. So I'll modify the file. And what I'm saying now is, on this drawing, there'll just be a half mil step there, and then just taper the whole thing down to the 28 mil. Well, that's 28 mil, wherever it is, yeah. So, I've printed a Mark II version of it. I was saying the first version had horizontal roofs in the print, which didn't come out, but they weren't critical features, so I was able just to put a chamfered face there, so it was able to print that face a lot better. The only critical point is how deep the oil seal seats down, which I've got a 7mm step there. And the 52mm oil seal fits in there. It's 52mm outside diameter. This isn't the correct seal, this is a 40mm internal diameter. I need a 35mm internal diameter seal for the shafts on the MX5 outputs. Now we've got the oil seal carriers made. This is the 35mm diameter that pushes into the inside of the bearing here, and then there's a 52mm diameter recess on this side that takes the oil seal, pushes in there, and then this oil seal runs on this part of the spigot. I've taken off the original dust seals that I had on there, took those off. And that just slides down onto there and runs in that face. So I need to push these into the housings. It should be a reasonable fit. going in fairly easily. Yes, pretty good fit. They will sit up about a millimetre by design, because I made that recess 7 millimetres deep, and it's an 8 millimetre deep seal. I can put some sealant on the spigot there that pushes in, just to seal it in and stop it working its way out, because it's a slide fit in there. Dab of grease on the spigot so I don't rip the seal, like that. Once that's bonded in, it will turn with the inner bearing. Open things up. At the moment, as you can see, it's just popping out, and that will bond into there, and it will go round with the differential, and this part stays. The outer part stays bolted to the chassis, and the inner part rotates all the time. And then when the differential turns differentially from the other one, it will spin inside that oil seal. I'll have one for the other side as well. And I also printed a couple for the smaller differential. Again, those should push in. Good fit. And there we have it. Very simple to make. And I've showed the design of these in my CAD system. Just printed them off in white PLA plastic material. It's pretty strong. Printed it with 1 millimetre thick walls and end faces. And then there's about a 20% infill. But it's, they do the job. They don't need to be very strong. They don't take much load on them. Just really to hold that seal out there. There's no axial loads on it or radial loads. That's both oil seal carriers attached, and the shafts are in. So being a differential, they can turn opposite directions and spin. You see the seal carrier is spinning at the same rate as the housing, but the output shafts can turn at a different rate, so they spin inside these oil seals. And then of course the outer flange stays stationary because it's bolted to the chassis.